Last week's U.S. withdrawal from Afghanistan, the Taliban's rapid takeover, and the death, chaos, and confusion that ensued caught many Americans by surprise. For some of the millions of U.S. service members who went to Afghanistan since 2001, the events of last week also come with mixed feelings about their service there and the allies left behind. I spoke with Rodger Pinto, who deployed to both Afghanistan and Iraq as an infantry paratrooper in the Army's 82nd Airborne from 2008 to 2014. He is also a member advocate for the nonpartisan group IAVA, Iraq and Afghanistan Veterans of America. So, Rodger, you were in the 82nd Airborne, served as infantry in Afghanistan. What were the kinds of things that you were doing on the ground with Afghan allies?
So there were a number of things we were doing on the ground with Afghan allies. You know, one, we have interpreters with us every day. We go outside the wire, whether that be clearing IEDs or doing key leader engagements in different villages. And we also had Afghan allies working on our bases. You know, just like your brothers and sisters in arms, our Afghan allies are risking as much, if not more, than we are.
What do you think that the bargain was that we made with the people of Afghanistan when we were there? When you're in these conversations with these people that you are working with and fighting with, what did they think was going to happen at the end of this?
I think that the bargain we struck with them was a recognition of the values we both share. You know, 99% of our Afghan allies and frankly, citizens of Afghanistan are very similar to, you know, us as Americans. They have the same values of, you know, taking care of their family, ensuring that they provide their kids with as much opportunities as they can afford, and putting in the hard work to do so. So we kind of presented that American dream to them. And it's very important that we ensure we follow through on the commitments we made.
If you can, I know one of the pictures that I saw. Tell me a little bit about the Afghan soldier that we're looking at there.
So that's a member of the Afghan Army. They were partnered with quite a few of our units in Afghanistan. And that particular picture is an infantry platoon with the 1st Special Troops Battalion, 82nd Airborne Division. And they're partnering with us as we provide security for a route clearance package, which is a group of combat engineers that are clearing IEDs off the road to ensure safety, not only for U.S. troops, but safe travel for, you know, everyday Afghans that are going to work and taking their children to school.
They knew that putting on a uniform and standing shoulder to shoulder with American and allied forces would mean that they would have a target on their back.
They absolutely do. And it's not that they did it for 2 or 3 months. In many cases, they've done it for 5, 10, and 20 years. Not only that, but unlike U.S. troops who know that their family is secure, safe, and sound at home in the United States, theirs are often still in a village, and they can expect a knock on their door from the Taliban any day. So in order to serve the United States, in order to partner with us, in Afghanistan, our Afghan allies made sacrifices every single day to ensure our safety.
Do you think that the past few weeks and the exit that the United States had from Afghanistan will have an effect on either the culture of the U.S. military or recruiting for the military?
You know, I think it will have an impact certainly on the culture in the U.S. military. It hasn't been the first time in the past several years where we've seen this kind of these kind of commitments, you know, falter. We saw in regards to our allies in Kurdistan. We saw it in regards to some of our allies in the fight in Iraq. And now we're seeing it in Afghanistan on an entirely different scale. If I were a recruit joining the military today, and I were seeing these images on TV, and I was reading the reports that are coming out in the news, I would be really concerned that I would go into combat potentially and have allies that recognize that the U.S. has not followed through on its word. For me, it's been like watching our country turn its back on our neighbor. These are members of our community at this point. They've served alongside us for decades. And while culturally Afghanistan may be very, very different, there are many, many shared values that I just don't think have been translated to the average, you know, U.S. citizen.
Veteran Rodger Pinto, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.